Earlier in the show, we discussed jiu-jitsu greats Jacare Souza and Mackenzie Dern. So that is setting up our top five for the week, which is the top five submission artists. Jessica, kick things off for us.
All right, my list. I have the upcoming uprising star, Mr. T-City, Brian Ortega. He is 15-0 with one no contest. He has seven submissions, notable submissions against Cub Swanson. Frankie Edgar, the first person to finish Frankie Edgar. This is extremely impressive. And this guy I love because he just jumps for submissions. He has no regard for position before submission, which is one of the things that we learn as a white belt. Next up, I have Mr. UFC flyweight champion since 2012, Demetrius Johnson. Now, you don't necessarily think of him as a submission artist, but he is. He has 11 submissions, and he does them all. Armbar, guillotine, rear naked choke, Americana. He has impressive transitions. He will pick you up and suplex you and then armbar you. This guy is insane to watch. I love it. And we cannot mention submission artists without mentioning the great Ronda Rousey.
Of course.
The 2008 bronze Olympic medalist. Nine submission, all by armbars, and almost all of them were within the first round. You know what she's going to do. And you still cannot stop it. She is one of the all-time greats.
Awesome.
And moving on, we have Mr. Jacare Souza, one of my favorite fighters, an amazing BJJ submission specialist. 17 submissions to his credit. Most of them are by guillotine, kimura, arm triangle. He's an amazing six-degree black belt. He's a judo black belt. He has a little bit more.
Six degree.
He's absolutely amazing. And we have number one, Damian Maia. He is a 4-3 black belt under Fabio Gurgel, BJJ world champion. He's the black belt among all black belts. He has 12 submission wins by rear naked choke. This guy, you know exactly what he's gonna do, and he does it anyway. He comes in, he takes you down, he takes your back, and submit you with a rear naked choke.
I don't think he threw one punch against Carlos, did he? Or he threw like one.
Maybe to set it up, to be like, hey, this is MMA, I can throw a punch.
Right. He's amazing. Jesus. He's amazing. Damian's absolutely
Get
amazing.
Out of here.
Solid list. All right, look at you. He put the
Get
belt
out
on.
Of here.
He put
Who
the belt on. Oh my goodness.
That looks good, doesn't it?
All of a sudden, the Thug Jitsu Master is here. Eve left a while ago, and the Thug Jitsu Master is here.
I want Eve back. Where did Eve go? Somebody go get Eve. I want him back. He was much nicer.
I'm awesome. So here's my list. I'm starting out. Our list look a little similar, but I'm starting out with the great. Dangerous heavyweight, Fabricio Werdum.
Right.
Fabricio Werdum, you don't see a lot of submissions in the heavyweight division unless you're looking at Fabricio Werdum. Fabricio Werdum likes to go out there and he finishes with everything. Rear naked chokes, triangles, arm bars. That is a submission machine in a big man in Fabricio Werdum. The next guy on my list is DJ.
Nice.
DJ is one of these guys who can do everything, and he's always looking for the submission, and he's armbarring. Armbars are easy to escape, but he's armbarring the fastest guys in the sport with solid technique and from all kinds of crazy positions. He's setting them up and walking them into it, or he's just exploding into these armbars. DJ can do it all. Great trainer in Matt Hume, and he's just a phenomenal fighter. Jacare Souza is my number three guy. Jacare Souza, like we talked about him earlier in the show, he's improved his striking game, but his submissions is where it's at. He goes out there and he hits arm triangles, kimuras. Kimuras are my favorite. He doesn't give up position in any of these submissions, and he takes out guys that are big, strong, powerful guys, isolates that joint, and you have no choice but to tap to save your joints. And then we got next? We got Damian Maia. Damian Maia, everybody knows Damian Maia. He's going to hit that double leg, take you down, take your back, and put you to sleep where you're going to tap. He does it to virtually everybody. He wasn't able to do it to Tyron Woodley, but he's able to do it to just about everybody out there. Once he gets a hold of you, you're going to have time and have an arm around your neck. And finally, we have Brian T-City Ortega.
Nice.
I love Brian Ortega, man. This kid is amazing. And here's the thing about submissions. It gets harder and harder to put submissions on guys as the sport evolves and people understand submissions. But T-City goes out there and he submits the best guys around. The only guy to finish Frankie Edgar, not with a submission, but everybody else. Look at the submission against Cub Swanson. Yep. He reset that guillotine while he's hanging off He reset his grip with one arm, still keeping that choke. T-City is a dangerous man.
Yeah.
I don't want that guy around my neck at all. I don't even want him around my house.
He's a nice guy. Especially when he gets him late in the game, too, right? When you're extra slippery and all that, and he's still just pulling it off.
Always just pulling submissions off.
Yeah, very good. Both of you guys, I mean, obviously there was a lot of crossover there, but
he
great list.
She was notes copying. Over breakfast.
Great
list.
I
saw him when he asked to borrow my pen this morning in our pre-meeting. I saw him looking over at my
notes,
so that's what happened.
But if you ain't cheating, you ain't trying. All right, coming up next is our social media segment, Rapid Fire. You guys sent in your questions to Eve and Jessica. Find out if yours got answered. Stay with us here on UFC Now.